I've made this video 3 weeks ago discussing the top 8 Harry Potter deleted scenes. Now for today's video, I wanted to make something different. The last video was about the deleted scenes that were left out of the movies, but now we'll be encountering some scenes that were never released to the public in the first place, not included anywhere, and no one had ever seen the film footage that was shot. So these pictures were made into scenes, but the reason why they never released them, just as the extended version, is unknown. So let's take a look at all these interesting shots. Before we get started, 97% of my viewers aren't subscribed, so please do me a favor and subscribe, it would be very much appreciated. Now let's get into the video. Let's start with Voldemort's death. After the Elder Wand refused to kill its owner master, and Voldemort's spell backfired and killed him instead, Voldemort fell backward, arms splayed. He hit the floor with a mundane finality. That wasn't actually the case in the movie, as Voldemort's body disappeared. It feels like he vanished or something, but this shot right here proves that he deleted a scene where Voldemort died a natural death like in the book. I think they should have stuck to the original one, as Voldemort was a human being after all, and practicing dark magic doesn't change it. The second deleted scene was during Bill and Flora's wedding. As we know from the book, Victor Krum attended the wedding, something that was never included in the movie. So the deleted scene is this one. Victor and Hermione dancing together in the wedding, and also Ron's jealous looks over Hermione. It's a really nice shot, considering that they were good friends, and Victor actually kept in contact with Hermione through letters, although there was nothing between the two but friendship. Victor Krum's presence in the wedding was noticeable in the book, as he had a conversation with the disguised Harry and wanting to start a duel with Xenophilius, but unfortunately none of that happened on screen. It was a shame that they didn't include this scene in the movie, or at least put in it in the extended version. Now the next scene is also during the wedding. Remus was seen in the movie bravely defending the barrow when it came under attack as Voldemort took over the ministry. But before that, I believe there was a shot, and I'm just assuming it was where Lupin is asking Harry to be the godfather of his son, Tiddy, as both he and his wife Tonks will eventually participate in the Battle of Hogwarts. So I think this scene was filmed and never released to the public. Now we're gonna jump to this scene. When Harry, Ron and Hermione were staying at 12 Grimmauld Place, Harry found a letter in Sirius' bedroom. The letter was written by Lily to his close friend Sirius, shortly after her son Harry's first birthday. Now this was only in the book, not in the movie, but there is this shot that proves the existence of this deleted scene we've never got to see. The second page of the letter was missing, leaving the last part of the letter to be cut off. However, the letter was as follows. Dear Sirius, thank you for Harry's birthday present. You'd think he'd been born in a room. James say he's got the look of a seeker, but then James would. We had a very quiet birthday tea, just us and old Bathilda, who dotes on Harry. Romley dropped by late in the day, but seemed down and didn't stay long. Jim is frustrated being shut up here, but Dumbledore still got his invisibility cloak, so he doesn't have much choice. By the way, Bathilda tells the most amazing stories about our old his master. I don't know how much to believe. Can it really be true that Dumbledore? There was also a picture of Harry riding on a toy broomstick found with the letter. Although the picture had been torn in half with one part missing, with only James and Harry in it. Harry searched the room for the lost part of the letter, but was unable to find it. And the reason for that is because just before Snape's death, he arrived at 12 Grimmauld. Snape found the letter, taking the second page of it, which contained Lily's signature and love, and the other half of the picture, which contained Lily for himself. Another scene was right in Grimmauld Place, when the Death Eaters were out of the house, and Harry, Ron and Hermione staring at them from the window. And again, this clip is nowhere to be found. Now the scene that I really wanted to see in the movie was about Lucius Malfoy. After being seen by ministry officials, Lucius was permanently sent to Azkaban with the rest of the Death Eater squad. Now in the movie, the story ends here, until we see him back in the Deathly Hallows Part 1. But this little picture here, showing Lucius in Azkaban, marked as prisoner with a personal number, so this scene shouldn't have been caught, considering how much bad and cruel Lucius was in the past. As he once before escaped banishment by claiming that he was under the Imperius curse. But this time, he was captured and thrown in Azkaban's cell. We needed to see this, at least a small clip, like they did with Bellatrix. Now this one here is a well-known topic. Peeves the Pottergeist. After appearing in all Harry Potter books and video games, Peeves never appeared in the films. But there was a scene with Peeves was filmed in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, but it was left on the cutting room floor, and to date has never even been released in any form. Peeves was filmed in the deleted scene by the British actor Rick Mayall, but unfortunately he never made it to the movie. There are a lot of other deleted scenes shots that were never released to the public, like this one in Snape's worst memories, where we can clearly see Lily Evans standing up for Snape. Dumbledore's army in the Gryffindor common room, after being caught by Umbridge, sitting there discussing the future of the army and how to deal and defeat this terrible news. The Order members after the Battle of the Department of Mysteries, probably witnessing Voldemort possessing Harry and how the power of Harry's love made it impossible for Voldemort to control him. I really would have loved each and every one of these scenes, and adding them to the extended version would be just a perfect job.